Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2015 Heritage Nashville Music Festival. We are so glad you are here joining us today. Please take a quick moment and make sure all your electronics are either silenced or turned off. Please also refrain from exiting or entering the auditorium while groups are performing. After the groups are done performing, one of the adjudicators will be coming up on stage to do a mini clinic with the ensemble. At that time, it is appropriate and okay to leave the auditorium or come back in, but please do so quietly. Speaking of our adjudicators, we are so glad they are here joining us and listening to our groups today. Please join me in welcoming, from Elkhart, Indiana, Mr. Robert Berheide. In the middle, from Nashville, Belmont University, Dr. Robert Gregg. And on my left, from Tulane University in New Orleans, Mendel Lee. And now I am pleased to announce from Huntington Valley, Pennsylvania, the Lower Moreland High School Symphonic Band under the direction of Eric Struth.
Thank you. Our second and final piece we're going to perform is a piece written by a dear friend of our program, Dr. Quincy Hilliard, who we'll actually be seeing in a couple weeks. And the day the clowns cried is based upon a tragedy that happened on July 6, 1944 in Hartford, Connecticut. Thousands of families had come to the city to see the Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey Circus. The show was only 20 minutes old, but the tent was engulfed in flames. 6,000 screaming spectators began rushing for the exits. The tragedy took the lives of 168 people, two-thirds of them were children. The day the clowns cried. Thank you.
so impressed with the size of this group. It's not a big one. I just hope it is. It's a bit better. I think it's just amazing to see this many people. Now, where are you all located in Pennsylvania? Close to? Near Philadelphia? It really is wonderful to see this size group, especially the fact that you play so well. You're doing things that usually secondary, which I guess this is. Yeah, there's a win on some also. I see. Okay. Well, that's very good. Sound wonderful. And I think what's also impressive to me is the control that you have. There's so many things that can be awkward as far as articulations, as far as being real precise on rhythms, and you got them. And that's one of the great things about your program. I just want to look at a couple of things. We're not going to spend a lot of time. But one thing that really impressed me was your dynamic contrast, which is really hard to do a lot of times. And so I really enjoyed listening to that. One of the things that there are some things that we might just make a little tweaking on. It's nothing great at all because you're doing it very well. But sometimes the dynamic contrast is not quite enough in a few places. But it's still very good. We start beginning again with the Ebrita Roca, and let's do a little bit of tweaking with the dynamic. This really is very good. Okay, here we go. Give a little more emphasis to the thing. Once again, same place. Hey, dude.